It's Advent once again, and here we are anxiously waiting for Christmas to come. New Yorkers don't like waiting. We don't like waiting online.
We don't like waiting for a turn.
We don't like waiting for somebody to finish speaking, so we interrupt.
Can you relate to that, Ethan?
Christmas is so much fun, but the waiting is torture.
We can't wait for
giving gifts,
candy canes,
gingerbread houses,
presents,
and more presents.
The smell of the Christmas tree.
Mary.
traveled on the many ships she saw coming and going past the pier. Mary would have found it exciting just to go visit another borough. She would often talk to the great lady of the harbor about her hopes and dreams until one day the great lady talked back.
Greetings, waiting one, the Lord is with you.
Mary was just a little freaked out.
Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God, and now you will continue your hope and bear a son, your child, and Jesus. You will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give you.
No one could stop the shabby, shabbily dressed pair from Brooklyn.
go across the street and find a nice, comfortable park bench.
It was getting dark when Mary and Joseph walked east on West 57th Street. They were given a tip by the concierge that there may be some shelter at the zoo. But before that, they got that far, Mary said, "It's time, Joseph."
Joseph rolled up his coat in a little plaza, sheltered by a marble planter, and there Mary gave birth to the baby boy. The exhausted family fell asleep, too tired to notice the bright light that shone above them.
Smell like smoke.
Wait, why do they smell like smoke?
Because they came from fire, get it?
For months, they had been noticing an unusual light emitting from Manhattan, and none of their calculations and charts could explain what was causing this anomaly. They took it as a sign heralding something or someone special. They set out on the journey to find the source of light. Instead of thinking they'd find a pot of gold at the end of their search, they brought with them gold, frankincense, and myrrh. At long last, their search was over. They reached their final destination. They walked up the steps to the plaza, eyes focused on the amazing glowing cube. Out of the corner of their collective eye, they saw a poor homeless family huddled together to keep warm.